Hello students, today we will start the second chapter, that is biological classification. In this chapter, you will study about two kingdom system of classification, three kingdom system of classification, four kingdom system of classification, and then five kingdom system of classification. Actually, in your textbook, these two classification systems have been given, that is, two kingdom and five kingdom. In the present day, we are following the five, it is the latest system of the classification, that is, five kingdom system of the classification. And we will study in detail about five kingdom system of classification. But you will start from the two kingdom system of classification. I will give a brief introduction also about three and four kingdom system of classification also. These two, three and four kingdom system of classification have been not given in your book. But I will explain about the three and four also. So let us start with the types of classification system. First, two kingdom system of classification. The two kingdom system of classification was given by Carolus Linnaeus in 1758. The Carolus Linnaeus, the father of taxonomy, earlier he divided all the living organisms into two kingdoms, and these two kingdoms were Plantae and Animalia. He kept all the plants in the kingdom Plantae and all the animals in the kingdom Animalia. So as per two kingdom system of classification, which was given by Carolus Linnaeus, the whole living organisms, the plants, animals, microorganisms, all the living world was divided into how many kingdoms? Two kingdoms. And these two kingdoms were Plantae and Animalia. The Plantae, he kept all the plants. I have written here algae, fungi, bacteria, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperm, angiosperms. He kept all these plants, even the bacteria also he kept into the kingdom Plantae. And he kept all the animals like porifera, these are the phylums I have written here, porifera, all the members of the porifera, cylindrata, platyhelminthes, mollusca, nematohelminthes, annelida, echinodermata, chordata, which includes amphibia, reptiles, species, mammals, means all the living organisms he kept into the kingdom Animalia. The Plantae had some common features. On that basis, he kept all the organisms into this one, into the Plantae. The criteria was the cell wall. As you know, in all the case of the plants, the cell wall is present. All the plants, they are having a big central vacuole, a food vacuole, or you can say vacuole, a very prominent, a big vacuole is there. All the plants, they perform what kind of nutrition? Autotrophic mode of nutrition. They can prepare their own food materials. And the Plantae, the members of the Plantae, they were unable to move from one place to the another place. But exceptions was there in some of the algae, microscopic algae, but the majority of the members of the plantae, they are unable to move. Their body is fixed. They can't change. Their body is stationary. They can't change their place. They can't move from one place to the another place. So no locomotion at all. Animalia has certain characteristics. Absence of the cell wall. There was no cell wall. In animals, cell wall is absent. The big central vacuole is absent in the case of animals. And animals, they perform what kind of nutrition? Heterotrophic mode of nutrition. And animalia, the animals, they are able to move from one place to another place. It means locomotion is present. So these all are the criteria on that basis. Carolus Linnaeus divided whole living world into two kingdoms, that is plantae and animalia. But so many shortcomings are there of the two kingdom system of classification. The two kingdoms do not fill all the parameters to keep the whole living world into the two kingdoms. So many drawbacks are there of the two kingdom system of classification. Then the two kingdom system of classification was followed by the three kingdom given by Haeckel. Still the three kingdom had certain drawbacks. Then later on four kingdom came. The four kingdom system of classification also had so many disadvantages. Then the five kingdom came, given by the R.S. Whittaker. We will study in detail later on. But here you can see that what are the shortcomings of the two kingdom system of classification. Why there was necessity to 3, 4, and 5 kingdom system of classification. This two kingdom system of classification had certain drawbacks, so many shortcomings. I have written here some of the points, and let me to define each point in detail. Prokaryotes. As you know, as per five kingdom system of classification, you have already studied in class 9. Just you can recall your memory. You can remember. Now the prokaryotes, they have got a separate kingdom, that is Monera, as per five kingdom system of classification. But in two kingdom system of classification, the prokaryotes, which include cyanobacteria and bacteria, they were kept into the plantae. This was not justice for the prokaryotes. For the bacteria is very unique. The prokaryotes are very unique. They don't have the well-developed nucleus. The well-developed nucleus, as you know, is absent in bacteria, in prokaryotic cell. Most of the cytoplasmic organelles like mitochondria, chloroplast, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, so many cell organelles are absent in the prokaryote. The prokaryotes, that is bacteria and cyanobacteria, their cell is very primitive. It is not advanced. So, how you can keep these prokaryotes like bacteria and cyanobacteria into the plantae? So, the bacteria couldn't get the proper place, and there was the need to make the separate kingdom for the prokaryotes because of their special features. The second you can see here, the Euglena. He kept actually Euglena into the kingdom. Carolus Linnaeus kept Euglena into the kingdom Animalia. But you can see the structure of, just you can remember the structure of the Euglena. The euglena performs mixotrophic mode of nutrition. Mixotrophic means autotrophic and heterotrophic both. When the light is present, it can synthesize their own food in the presence of sunlight. And when light is absent, the euglena can take the food from outside. So euglena is very special regarding the mode of nutrition. It performs autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition both. That is mixotrophic mode of nutrition. It means it has the features of both plant and animals both. It is very unique. Even the euglena don't have the outer cell wall. Because of the absence of the cell wall, he kept euglena into the kingdom Animalia. But as per nutrition is there, it performs autotrophic mode of nutrition as well as heterotrophic. So it was also a controversy regarding the euglena, whether euglena should be kept into the kingdom Plantae or Animalia. Euglena couldn't get the proper place as per two kingdom system of classification. Now the problem was with the viruses also. Still the viruses, even as per five kingdom system of classification also, the viruses do not have the proper place, don't have the proper kingdom where the viruses should be kept. As you know, viruses are the connecting link in between the living and non-living. The viruses has the characteristics of living things also and non-living things also. When the viruses come into the contact of the human body or any host or in the contact of the living things, the viruses, they multiply. And as you know, the multiplication is the characteristic feature of the living things. And when the viruses, they are outside to the body, they are not in the contact of the host, they are not contact in the contact of the living things, they are dead. They do not multiply outside to the body. Even you can keep the viruses in the form of a crystal for so many years. So viruses, shows the characteristic of living as well as non-living both. The viruses, even they don't have the cellular structure, they are just live as a particle. They are just act as the particle. It is made up of the two components, nucleic acid and protein. The nucleic acid is either DNA and RNA, and the nucleic acid is coated or covered by the protein coat. So because of no cellular structure, because the viruses do not multiply outside to the host body, they are non-living. But when the viruses come into the contact of the host, they multiply, and this multiplication is the feature of the living. So viruses are very, very special. And as per two kingdom system of classification, even the viruses also couldn't get the proper place in this two kingdom system of classification. Now, I have written here slime molds. The slime molds, Linnaeus, he kept slime molds into the kingdom Animalia. The slime molds are also very special. As per five kingdom of system of classification, now the slime molds have been kept into the protista. But Carinus Linnaeus, he kept slime molds into the kingdom Animalia, but slime molds are also very special. The slime mold has the cell wall in the vegetative phase. Actually, it has two phases, each individual, the vegetative phase and reproductive phase. So, cell wall absent in the vegetative phase, but during the reproductive phase, the cell wall is present. So, in the life cycle of the slime mold, cell wall is present in the reproductive phase, while it is absent in the vegetative phase. And as you know, cell wall is present in the animals. So, this is also a very special type of the living organism. It has both the characteristics of the plants and animals both. So, it was a big problem for slime molds also, that where the slime mold should be placed, in which kingdom the slime molds may be included. Now, the lichens. As you know, the lichen is the symbiotic association of the symbiotic relationship of the algae and fungi. The algae prepares the food. Algae gives food to the fungus. In return, fungus gives shelter to the algae, as well as it also absorbs water and nutrients and give to the algae. So, algae gives food material to the fungus. As you know, fungus, they are non-chlorophyllous. They are unable to prepare their own food. So, in this relationship, fungus gets food from the algae, and in return, the algae gets shelter as well as water and nutrients through the fungus, and both they live together in the form of lichens. So, lichens are also very special, and the lichens also couldn't get the proper position as per two kingdom system of classification. Now, the unicellular and multicellular organisms. The unicellular and multicellular, as you know, as per two kingdom system of classification, all the living organisms, whether they were unicellular or multicellular, unicellular includes amoeba, paramecium, euglena, chlamydomonas. The multicellular, like so many algae, fungus, bryophyte, pteridophytes. Overall, Carolus Linnaeus, he kept unicellular, multicellular in both of the kingdoms. How you can correlate a single cell organism with the multicellular, whose body is well developed? And he kept all, he couldn't differentiate the unicellular organisms to the multicellular, and he kept all the unicellular and multicellular organisms in these two kingdoms. As for five kingdom system of classification, as you know, the unicellular eukaryotes, they have got a separate kingdom, that is protista. But as per two kingdom system of classification, the unicellular and multicellular couldn't get the proper position, proper place. So that's all for two kingdom system of classification. This is very, very important. I request you all, while I am teaching, I am not going very fast. I am taking pause also in between. And it's my humble request to all the boys to make the notes, to make a separate notebook of bio and write all these headings. I hope you have completed the first chapter. I have already given the assignment. Most of the boys, I got the phone that they have completed. It's very good. And in second chapter also, today you will start chapter 2. You will write like this: two kingdom system of classification. Which scientist given the two kingdom system classification? In which year? What was the name of these two kingdoms, Plantae, Animalia? On which parameters Carolus Linnaeus divided these two kingdoms? Then you will make a separate notes, shortcomings of the two kingdom system of classification. So all these headings are very, very important. So let us start now the next one, that is three kingdom system of classification. Here you can write three kingdom system of classification. The three kingdom system of classification was given by Ernest Haeckel. Ernest Haeckel in 1866. Please note down, Ernest Haeckel was given the three kingdom system of classification, and he made these three kingdoms. These kingdoms are Plantae, Animalia, and Protista. And I told you, as per two kingdom system of classification, only two kingdoms were made. These were Plantae and Animalia. Now you can see one more kingdom was added as per three kingdom system of classification, and that was Protista. Ernest Haeckel, he kept all the unicellular eukaryotic organisms like amoeba, paramecium, euglena, clay mydomonas, slime molds into a separate kingdom, that was Protista. As I have already taught Plantae and Animalia, but he kept unicellular eukaryotes into the kingdom like amoeba, paramecium, euglena, Hey, Mydomonas, etc. into the kingdom. But still, the three kingdom system had so many shortcomings. In this kingdom also, the Monera, the bacteria, the viruses, the fungus, they couldn't get the proper position. So now the after three kingdom system of classification, then the four kingdom classification was came. Four kingdom system of classification. As per four kingdom system of classification, it was given by Copeland. These kingdoms were Plantae, then Animalia, then Protista, and he added one more kingdom, and that was Monera. So you can see here, as per four kingdom system of classification, how many kingdoms were made? Four: Plantae, Animalia, Protista, and Monera. He kept all the plants into the kingdom Plantae, Copeland. He kept all the animals into the kingdom Animalia. He kept all the unicellular eukaryotic, all the unicellular eukaryotic organisms into the kingdom Protista, and he kept unicellular prokaryotic organism like bacteria, blue green alga into the kingdom Monera. The four kingdom system of classification also had the shortcomings. Still in four kingdom, the fungi, which is very special, as you know, fungus is non-chlorophyllous. The body is called mycelium. The fungus is heterotrophic. In mode of nutrition, the fungus couldn't get the proper place. So the four kingdom system of classification was followed by which kingdom? Five kingdom system of classification. And as per five kingdom system of classification, one more this kingdom system of classification was given by R.H. Whittaker. And R.H. Whittaker, he made how many kingdoms? You can see, first Plantae, Animalia, Protista, Monera, and this one is the fungi. And this kingdom system of classification is more acceptable, and this five kingdom system of classification fulfills all the criteria which are required to classify all the living world, all the living organisms, most of the organisms. On the basis of their features, they have got their position as per five kingdom system of classification. And this five kingdom system of classification, we will study in detail. In this chapter, I will explain you about these five kingdom system of classification, about Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, Animalia. All these five kingdoms we will study in detail later on. So tomorrow I will start the five kingdom system of classification, and we will also study about the characteristics of the five kingdom system of classification. Each kingdom we will study in detail. So before I close this lesson, I am giving you a few questions. You please note down as the assignment. Question number one. What is two kingdom system of classification? What is two kingdom system of classification? What is two kingdom system of classification? Full stop. Name the scientist who gave two kingdom system of classification. Name the scientist who gave two kingdom system of classification. Question number two. What are the criteria of two kingdom system of classification? What are the criteria of two kingdom system of classification? Question number three. Write shortcomings of two kingdom system of classification. Write shortcomings, shortcomings. Write shortcomings of two kingdom system of classification. Next, question number four. Name the kingdoms as per three kingdom system of classification. Name all the kingdoms as per three kingdom system of classification. And the last question is, name the scientist who gave three kingdom system of classification. Name the scientist who gave three kingdom system of classification. Tomorrow we will start five kingdom system of classification, that is Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. So thanks to you all. I will see you tomorrow. Thanks.